Hi, good morning. This is Trina here to discuss about atomic structure. So already I have covered three lectures in the atomic structure. Today I will describe the fourth lecture of the atomic structure. So in my personal information, I have given my contact number and email ID. So if you have any doubt regarding the chapter, you can communicate with me. And the most important part, that is the course page, and I have uploaded inter-study material, all the probable questions, semester questions, and the solved problems. So first you join with my code. I hope that you have already joined because it is the fourth lecture, and then you can access all the study materials. So in the chemistry subject, the subject code is CH101 for odd semester, CH201 for even semester. This course is for BTech undergraduate students, and the streams are CSE-IT Civil Mechanical for even semester and Electrical ECE and BME for odd semester. So here the credits 3, contact hours 35, and weekly I will take 3 lectures. And the prerequisite knowledge required 12th standard. The course objective, here the students will learn several concepts of chemistry. And the course outcome, in the course outcome, students will be able to describe the fundamental properties of atoms and molecules, and also the atomic structure. The entire lecture plan is given here. So I am covering the first module, that is the atomic structure. The module 1, the atomic structure. Already I have covered the first lecture about the Rutherford model, drawbacks, Bohr's model. So in my first lecture, you have learned the Rutherford experiment, that the beam of alpha electron, how it is deflected by the thin gold plate, it is shown there. And based on the deflection, you also know the conclusion that there is a small space occupied by the nucleus in an atom. So you learn the structure of the atoms from there. You got the idea that first how the nucleus, the concept of nucleus comes. But this model was not the flawless, and he was unable to explain the stability of the atoms. So scientist Niels Bohr modified the Rutherford's model, and he told about different orbit, like n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3 in this way. So inner orbit and the outer orbit, so it contains a specific energy level. So outer orbit has the higher energy level, inner orbit has the lower energy level. So when any electron moves from the lower energy level to the higher energy level, it will absorb energy. When it moves from the higher or outer orbit to the inner orbit or lower energy level, it will release energy. So in the second lecture, you got the application of Bohr's model. So you have learned to calculate the radius the velocity of electron and also the energy of the electron. And as you can calculate the energy of electron at different orbit, so you also can get the energy difference between two orbit. Like say, how we get the hydrogen spectrum? When hydrogen at the say inner level to the outer level, when it is moving, any atom, any electron is moving to the outer level from the inner level, say n is equal to 1 to n is equal to 2, so it will absorb energy. Or say from n is equal to 2 to n is equal to 1, it is moving, so it will release energy. So how much energy it will release? So we can get it from EF minus EI. Then from this difference, we can get the spectrum. And also we have learned the Sommerfeld model. We have learned the different quantum number. There are four quantum number. We have learned this. And also we have learned different orbital like S, P, D and F. So today, it is the last lecture, the fourth lecture, that is the application of quantum numbers, Heisenberg principle and Schrodinger's equation. So what we will learn today? Application of quantum numbers, Heisenberg principle and Schrodinger's equation. So you will be able to describe the fundamental properties of atoms, molecules and atomic structure. And if you like to get the books, you can avail it from our library. So now, first I will tell about few principles that how the electron fills in the orbital. So first is the Apou principle, the order of filling orbitals, that is the Apou principle. So what it tells? Apou is a German word meaning building up or construction. Moving from one atom to the next in the periodic table, the electronic structure of the next atom can be determined by fitting an extra electron into the next available orbital. Electrons fill low energy orbital closer to the nucleus before they fill higher energy ones. If there is a choice between orbital of equal energy, they fill the orbitals singly as far as possible before pairing up. Okay, so always, like the human being, always the atoms, electrons also like to be at the lower energy level. So first, which one is filled up? First, the low energy orbitals filled up, which is closer to the nucleus. It is the inner orbital. And then, next, the higher energy level, higher orbital is filled up. So this filling of orbitals singly where possible is known as Hund's rule. It only applies to orbital with exactly the same energies as with p orbitals, for example. It helps to minimize the repulsion between electrons and so make the atoms more stable. The diagram, not to the scale, summarizes the energies of the orbitals up to the 4p level. Okay, so you can understand that one is it is the lower energy level. So here you can see that lower to higher energy level, you can see this, it is the lower energy level. So it is energy level is moving lower to the higher energy level. So this is the 1s. So next 2s, 2p, this is the higher energy level than 1s. Then 3s, 3p, 3d is higher energy level, like 2s, then 2p is higher energy level, then 3s is higher energy level than 2p, 3p is higher than 3s, 3d is higher than 3p, 4s is higher than 3d. In this way the energy level increases. So always the electron has a tendency to become in the lower energy level. So first 1s will be filled up, then 2s, 2p will be filled up. So like hydrogen, it has only one electron, so it will first fill up the 1s. So Hund's rule. Hund's rules refer to a set of rules that German physicist Friedrich Hund formulated around 1927, which are used to determine the term symbol that corresponds to the ground state of multi-electron atom, which for a given electron configuration, the term with maximum multiplicity has the lowest energy. The multiplicity is equal to 2s plus 1, where s is the total spin angular momentum for all electrons. Therefore, the term with lowest energy is also the term with maximum s. Number two, for a given multiplicity, the term with the largest value of the total orbital angular momentum quantum number L has the lowest energy. For a given term in an atom with outermost subshell half filled or less, the level with the lowest value total angular momentum quantum number J for the operator J is equal to L plus S lies lowest in energy. In the outermost shell is more than half filled, the level with the highest value of J is the lowest in energy. Okay, so you have understood the same thing, that first the lower energy level will be filled up, then gradually the higher energy level will be filled up. The Pauli's exclusion principle. It states that in an atom, no two electrons can have identical four set of quantum numbers. You know there are four quantum numbers, M, N, L, ML, and MS, the spin. So all, if like L, N, L, ML, same, but MS must be different. The spin must be different, the rotation. So consider the argon's electron configuration, that is the argon. So it will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 2s2, 3p6. Can you tell that how many electrons are there in argon? Yes, it is 18. Okay, so as per Hund's law, we know that first it will fill up the lower energy level. So first two will come at 1s, so it is a 2 electron. Then in the second level, s orbital will be filled up by 2 electron, so 2s2, then 2p6, that px, py, pz. So px will get 2, py will get 2, pz will get another 2. Okay, so how many left? Here we have allotted 6 plus 2 plus 2, that is 10. So we have 8 more electrons. So it will come to the next level, that is 3s. So 3s2 and 3p6. So here is also p has px, py and pz. So 3px will get 2 electrons. 3py will get 2 electrons. 3pz will get 2 more electrons. So it is the configuration of argon. The exclusion principle, Pauli's exclusion principle, what is it? It is telling that the 2 electrons, it states that in an atom, no 2 electrons can have identical 4 sets of quantum number. The exclusion principles asserts that every electron in the argon atom in unique state, okay, it will not be similar. The 1s level can accommodate 2 electrons with identical N, L and ML quantum numbers. Argon's pair of electrons in the 1s orbital satisfy the exclusion principle because they have opposite spins, meaning they have different spin quantum number. Yes, one spin plus half, another spin minus half. So instead of saying plus half or minus half, we can say the spin up and spin down. So if what it is the main thing of the Pauli's exclusion, then there is no identical electron. If the all the quantum number like L, N, L and ML same, but MS, the spin, must be different. So it is about the rotation. One is plus up and that is minus up, or you can say that spin up or spin down. So that is the main thing of the Pauli exclusion principle. So now the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, Schrodinger wave equation. So Heisenberg stated that the more precisely we can define the position of an electron, the less certainty we are able to define its velocity, and is vice versa. If say del x is the uncertainty in defining the position and del v the uncertainty in the velocity, the uncertainty principle may be expressed mathematically that del x into del v greater than is equal to h by 4 pi. And you know that h is Planck's constant and its value is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule per second. This implies that it is impossible to know both the position and the velocity exactly. So the concept of an electron flowing a definite orbit where its position and the velocity are known exactly must therefore be replaced by the probability of finding an electron in a particular position or in a particular volume of space. The Schrodinger wave equation provides a satisfactory description of an atom in this term. Solutions to the wave equation are called wave function and given the symbol psi. The probability of finding of electron at a point in space whose coordinate x, y and z is psi squared x, y, z. Okay, so from the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, the Schrodinger wave equation, we come to know the position of the electron in the space. So basically electrons remain in the form of cloud. So it is very difficult to tell that just now in this position. So we can get from the Schrodinger wave equation that the position of electron in the space. So we take the three dimension x, y and z. So here we have derived for a standing wave of wavelength lambda whose amplitude at a given point along x may be described by the function of fx. This square fx by dx square is equal to minus 4 pi square by lambda square fx. An electron is considered as a wave which moves in only one dimension, then d square psi by dx square is equal to minus 4 pi square divided by lambda square psi. So if we consider that x, y and z direction, the three direction that for the three dimensional figure, we get d square psi by dx square plus d square psi by dy square plus d square psi by dz square is equal to minus 4 pi square by lambda square psi. So using the symbol delta instead of three partial differential, instead of this three partial differential, these are the partial differential. If we use delta, this is shortened to the equation delta square psi is equal to minus 4 pi square lambda square psi. The relationship, Broglie relationship, states that lambda is equal to h by mv, where h is Planck's constant, m is the mass of an electron, and v is its velocity. Hence, we are getting that delta square psi is equal to 4 minus 4 pi square m square v square by h square into psi. So we get the equation 1. Now, however, the total energy of the system E is made up of kinetic energy K plus the potential energy V. So K is equal to E minus V. It is a total energy. E is the total energy. E is total energy. This is the sum of kinetic energy plus potential energy. So K is equal to E minus V. But the kinetic energy we know very well, that half mv square. So half mv square is equal to E minus V. And V square is equal to 2 by m into E minus V. So substituting for V square in equation 1 gives well-known form of Schrodinger equation. So in this way, we get here the Schrodinger equation. So it is very important. It is the delta square psi plus 8 pi square m divided by h square into E minus V into psi is equal to 0. So you know that all representation like h is the Planck's constant, in this way you know. So acceptable solution to the wave equation, that is solution which are physically possible, must have certain properties. Like psi must be continuous, psi must be finite, psi must be single valued. The probability of finding the electron over all the space from plus infinity to minus infinity must be equal to 1. Okay, so you have learned the probability of finding an electron at a point xyz is chi square. So we can write that integration minus infinity to plus infinity chi square dx dy dz is equal to zero. So now if I summarize what you have learned today, you have learned the Hund's rule, you have learned the Pauli's exclusion principle, and also you have learned the Schrodinger wave equation, that is the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, Schrodinger wave equation. So you have learned that how we can tell about the different quantum numbers. Okay, now let's solve a quiz. I have given a quiz, so now let's solve it. Okay, just a minute. Okay, so here I have given the code. So you have to join to start the game. Okay, so I'm just showing with just one player. If you are not correct, just to show you, then you will get 0% accuracy. And when there will be different players, then what will happen? Those who will do the good score, they will come above. And those who will get the bad score, they will come below. In this quiz, also you can see that who is the first, who is the second, who is third, who is fourth. In this way, you can see. Yes, correct. When you will do the correct answer, so you will get the accuracy. Okay, this is also correct. So you have seen the, if you were doing the wrong, then your marks is the points is reduced, and when you are doing good, then your marks will be increased. So the next question. Okay, so my score is increasing. When there will be the all students, the competition will be very enjoying. Okay, so I'm sending this link as your homework. Then you can play it. So become the first because there is no other competitor. So you play at the home, you will enjoy very much. Okay, so I hope that today you enjoyed my class very well. And now I am ending my session. Thank you everyone.